Hello world, welcome to quick tip number 15, AEB. A normal human being has a dynamic range of about 24 stops. A normal camera, 5. And a dynamic range camera, 7. A high dynamic range, 10 stops. So, to make a high dynamic range image with a normal range camera, we need to do AEB, or auto exposure bracketing. In principle, it means we take the same image, but with different exposure values, positive and negative. I have made a small plan, the manual bracketing, and that plan includes a path, a short one, and a marker. This marker is important. It will tell you the drone heading and, of course, the pitch. This is required for your image, depending, of course, on what you want to take. Here I take 170 degrees and a gimbal pitch of 5. The reason I use a marker is that I have full freedom of my plan. That means I can just change any heading or any gimbal pitch that I need for my picture. This is a standard AEB with 5 images. Minus 2.3 to plus 2.7, so 5 stops dynamic range extra. And at the end, of course, a reset of the EV values for the next image. Now let's see the preview. You see the heading of 170 degrees and the pitch of minus 5. In the marker properties, I can change them to any value that is required for my perfect image. As you can see, I have changed the parameters of this image in the marker settings without any problem. Now let's fly and take the images. As you can see, I'm using the Spark. It has a dynamic range of about 4.5 to 5 stops, 1080 pixels, and in the images only 4x3 picture format. Please note the 5 different EV settings. Next step is to process the images. First, let's see and compare the 5 images. There are a lot of programs to do HDR merge. I use Affinity Photo. This is of course not free. But there are a number of free applications for this. First, we make an image without tone mapping. Now we make an image of the same 5 photos, but with tone mapping. We have some presets on the left, but for this sample, I'll just use the natural. And for the last image, I use manual, so I can color grade every image to my own needs. Especially with exposure, highlights and shadows, you can create really nice coloring effects. And of course, you can use colors to even more detail.